student of Shivashi Institute of Forensic Science. So today I'm going to explain you about what is data recovery and how it will be performed. So my topic is data recovery. I'm going to explain about the introduction to data recovery. What is data loss? Introduction to data loss, fact and data, causes of data loss, principle of data recovery, slack space, and some file recovery systems. What is data recovery? Data recovery, it is the process of restoring data that has been lost accidentally, deleted, or corrupted, or made inaccessible. So data recovery refers to the securing of data from failed or compromised hardware systems. In data forensics, the term refers to technique for obtaining hard to get. Espionage is the term refers hard to get data, usually during hardware or system failure, or when system data has been erased. Recovery of lost data can be performed on a variety of storage media like the hard drive, the pen drive, the floppy disk, the USB, SD cards, memory cards, etc. And the different storage devices have one thing in common. These all storage devices have one thing in common. That is the all carry set of electronic equipment, which may abruptly fail, which may be failed, maybe damaged or simply stop working, and all the stored data may be compromised. So what is introduction to data loss? The exact understanding scenario of data loss is as important as recovering your lost data. So we ye understand karna zaruri hai ki data loss hai kya, hota kaise hai, tabhi hum data ko acche se recover kar paye. So data loss jo hai वो हम नॉर्मली ये समझते हैं कि हमने कोई फाइल डिलीट कर दी या हम सब फाइल ओपन नहीं हो पा रही है, दैट मीन्स हमारी वो फाइल करप्ट हो चुकी है, डेटा लॉस, हमारा डेटा लॉस हो चुका है. लेकिन समटाइम्स हम क्या करते हैं कि सिंपली हम डिलीट कर देते हैं फाइल को और उसकी जो लोकेशन में हमने जो सेट किया था वो वहाँ पर नहीं मिल रही है, तो हम समझते हैं कि वो परमानेंटली लॉस हो गया है. ऐसा नहीं होता है, हम रिसाइकल बिन फोल्डर में जाकर हमारी वो फाइल को रिकवर कर सकते हैं. ठीक है. एंड डेटा लॉस जो है वो किन किन सिचुएशंस डेटा लॉस जो है वो सिचुएशन होती है जो कि इंक्लूड करती है इनएक्सेसिबिलिटी ऑफ स्टोरेज डिवाइस. हमें कोई स्टोरेज डिवाइस पेन ड्राइव में हम उसका एक्सेस नहीं कर पा रहे हैं, दैट मीन्स हम समझते हैं कि डेटा लॉस होता है. और या फिर हमने कोई एक पर्टिकुलर प्लेस पर कोई फाइल सेव करी और हमें वहाँ पर नहीं मिल रहा है, दैट मीन्स हमारे डिवाइस में प्रॉब्लम है, ऐसा लोग हम सोच लेते हैं. तो जो कॉमन रीजन है डेटा लॉस के वो होते हैं लॉजिकल और फिजिकल करप्शन ऑफ द ड्राइव. लॉजिकल या फिजिकल करप्ट होना ड्राइव का इज द मेन रीजन ऑफ द डेटा लॉस. सो आफ्टर विच इट विल मेक योर डेटा इनएक्सेसिबल. हमारी ड्राइव जो है वो करप्ट हो चुकी है, तो हमको क्या करते हैं, हमको कोई डेटा को एक्सेस नहीं करने देते, इनएक्सेसिबल कर देते हैं या तो खुद ही बिल्कुल नॉन एक्सेसिबल हो जाते हैं. तो हम ट्रेडिंग आते हैं जो स्टोर कर सकते हैं ना, वहाँ से कुछ एक्सेस कर सकते हैं. तो डेटा जो है वो स्टोर होता है हार्ड ड्राइव में, हार्ड ड्राइव के पेटर्स पर जो कि स्पिन करते हैं 800 से 1500 रोटेशन पर मिनट पर. और जो रीड और राइट एक्चुएटर आर्म्स हैं वो रीड करता है और राइट करता है डेटा को वेरी क्लोज डिस्टेंसेस ऑफ द प्रोटीन सर्वर्स. क्योंकि जो प्लेटर है उसके अंदर प्लेटर स्पिंडल्स अराउंड प्लेटर अराउंड द स्पिंडल एंड आर्म असेंबलर रीड एंड राइट हैंड. सो रीड एंड राइट हैंड हेल्प्स द return and reading of the data from the papers. So some facts and data about the recovery of data or the data loss. So most data loss is caused by human error rather than malicious attacks according to UK studies released in 2016. In fact, human error accounted for almost 2/3 of the incidents reported to the UK Information Commissioner's Office. The most common type of breach occurs when someone sends data to the wrong person. Here are some causes of data loss. So, common causes of data loss include power outages, natural disaster, equipment failure or malfunction, accidental deletion of data, unintentionally formatting a hard drive, damaged hard drive, read write write are damaged, software crash ho gaya, logical error, firmware corruption, program continue use kar rahe hain computer ko, ye hamare side of pehle hote hain, physical damage of the hard drives, laptop theft ho gaya hai, ya phir hamare chal ka pani se gir gaya hai computer ka. And in fact, it's a little bit of a logical problem. मतलब क्या हो सकता है कि जो हमारे ये एक ट्रेडिशनल और मॉडर्न हार्ड ड्राइव दोनों पर हो सकता है. तो लॉजिकली पहले या फिर डैमेज कब बोलते हैं हम, जब हम एक्सेस नहीं कर पाते हैं ड्राइव, जब हम ड्राइव को एक्सेस नहीं कर पाते हैं, हम वो डेटा को एक्सेस नहीं कर पाते हैं, तो उसको हम लॉजिकल पैनल बोलते हैं. तो फाइल सिस्टम करप्शन, ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम पैनल, रजिस्ट्री डैमेज हो जाएगा उसका, ये सब टॉप कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग फैक्टर्स होते हैं लॉजिकल हार्ड ड्राइव के अंदर. और ये प्रिवेंट स्टोर कंटेंट विद नॉर्मली एक्सेस बाय द यूजर. और फिजिकल फेलियर में क्या होता है कि जो परमानेंट फेलियर होती है एनी स्टोरेज डिवाइस की, कॉम्प्रोमाइजिंग फिजिकल डैमेज टू इलेक्ट्रॉनिक इक्विपमेंट ऑफ द स्टोरेज डिवाइस. तो प्रीवियसली आई एम शोन यू द डायग्राम ऑफ द हार्ड ड्राइव. सो बेसिकली हार्ड ड्राइव कंसिस्ट ऑफ द वेरियस सेक्टर्स. तो व्हेन रीड एंड राइट आर रोटेट्स कंटिन्यूअसली एंड रेगुलरली एट अ पर्टिकुलर प्लेस, द चांसेस ऑफ द रप्चर डैमेज ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर एरिया इज द हाईएस्ट. सो द परमानेंट डैमेज एट एनी सेक्टर इज द कॉज ऑफ फिजिकल फेलियर, और इट मे बी कॉज ऑफ फिजिकल फेलियर. The kind of failure prevent access to the storage device and will require you to take it to data recovery expert so you can get back your vulnerable files. Physical failure अगर हो एक बार हम logical failures को restore कर सकते हैं. Logical failures से हम restore कर लेते हैं data easily. But physical failures को जो हम कर देते हैं वो हम कर सकते हैं. Chances are low to recover data, but it is one ever when they normally much better. So, principle of data recovery. Data recovery is the process of finding and recovering data in which there may be some risk for no orchestration can be anticipated or pre-arranged. It means maybe there will be some unexpected things happening. So, you need to reduce the danger in data recovery to the lowest. Principle of data recovery, backup all the data in your hard disk. Prevent the equipment from being damaged again. Don't write anything to the device on which you want to recover data. Backup the data recovered in time. Principle of data recovery. So data recovery is based on the principle that no data disappears until it is overwritten. So as each file system set its own rule for managing data, the chance for successful data recovery depend greatly on the file system or storage is formatted with. हर फाइल सिस्टम का, हर फाइल सिस्टम मीन्स द फाइल स्टोरेज डिवाइस और द फाइल स्टोरिंग टेक्निक इज डिफरेंट. एंड द चांसेस ऑफ डेटा रिकवरी इज मोर डिपेंड्स ऑन द फाइल सिस्टम. इंट्रोडक्शन टू स्लैक स्पेस. स्लैक स्पेस इज द लेफ्टओवर स्टोरेज दैट एग्जिस्ट ऑन अ कंप्यूटर्स हार्ड ड्राइव, डिस्क ड्राइव. When a computer file does not need all the space, it has been allocated by the operating system. The examination of slack space is an important aspect of computer forensics. To understand why slack space plays an important role in e-discovery, one must first understand how data is stored on computers that have hard disk drives. It's quite amazing to learn about. So the computers with hard disk drives store data in a sealed until that contain a stack of circular spinning disk called platters. Each platter is composed of logically defined spaces called sectors, and by default, most operating system sectors are configured to hold no more than 5.2 bytes per computer. If a text file that is 400 bits is saved to disk, the sector will have 112 byte of extra space left over. Technically, file slack space is the difference between its logical and physical size. The logical size of a file is determined by the file's actual size and is measured in bytes. The physical size of a file is determined by the number of sectors that are allocated The file in most operating systems, including Windows, sectors are clustered in groups of 4 by default, which means that each cluster has 2048 bytes. The logical size of the blue file below is 1280 bits. So it is the logical size. Each sector is a 512 bits. That means this is 512 bits. Okay. So this file was allocated a cluster of 4 512 bit byte sectors. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, हाफ सब्जेक्ट है, जो बचा हुआ रिमेनिंग हाफ है ये हमारा स्लैक स्पेस में है। We have four 5.2 bytes, that is 5.2 into 4, so that is 5.4. That's all about it. Okay, so my personal domain space is 768 bytes. File recovery of FAT and NNTFS is nothing but the file storage systems. Microsoft usually use two common file storage systems, that is FAT file allocation table and NTFS new technology file system. So firstly we will understand about the FAT. So FAT file system was first developed in the mid-1970s. So Microsoft of FAT 32 have released with Windows 95. Or remains the standard format for removable storage media today. The new technology file system NTFS was commercially released by Microsoft in the mid-1990s and was designed to supersede FAT. Today, FAT remains popular for removable devices, storage devices, for simplicity, portability, and compatibility reasons, while NTFS is now widely used for home and office installations. Advantages of NTFS over FAT include, so NTFS ke advantages kya hai as comparison to FAT. File level security NTFS mein zyada hoti hai, file compression or encryption NTFS mein rehta hai, reliability or system recovery NTFS mein chances ke zyada hote hain. Purpose kya hai, design karne ka as a flexible scalable storage device for large volume and RAID devices. तो रिकवरी ऑफ फॉर्मेटेड डिस्क कैसे हम रिकवर कर सकते हैं फॉर्मेटेड डिस्क को, तो NTFS जो है वो रिकवरी प्रिंसिपल पर रिकवरिंग अ फॉर्मेटेड NTFS डिस्क आर एसेंशियली द सेम। NTFS रिकवरी प्रिंसिपल फॉर रिकवरिंग अ फॉर्मेटेड NTFS डिस्क एसेंशियली द सेम, वो वाली सेम थिंग्स। ओके, सो NTFS रिकवरी सिस्टम उसका प्रिंसिपल ऑफ नॉर्मल डेटा का रिकवरी सेम होता है। So at the highest level, recover my file search for missing NTFS partition which it rebuilt the and displays in the search results screen. This then search for additional individual and empty entry on the disk to recreate the file and folder. So let's see how to recover it. Let's recover data by recover tool. So here is the tool. First of all, I will just open the Recuva tool. By opening the Recuva tool, so it was opening. Wait for a minute. So just next, all files be selected. Then next, then here we can select the location where the files which I want to recover. So in this video, I wanted to recover the file which is located in the C drive. Stop. The scanning process, so it takes time. You have to wait for it approximately 5 to 10 minutes it will take. There are so many files in it. I'm just concerned because there are so many files and it will take more time, approximately 2 to 3 hours to recover that. So I just cancelled it and the remaining files is 13,000 or something. So that are analyzing for damage. It's going to be in progress. 7%. Stage 1 is the scanning by terminated files. Recuva 2 is the scanning by drive C for all the deleted files it have. Estimated time uses 40 seconds, 30 seconds, 35 seconds, 25 seconds, 20 seconds, 15 seconds, 10 seconds. Just a little bit more. As you can see, we need to scan the first stage to complete the first stage. Stage that is analyzing damage. Deleted files will be damaged by stroke 2. So, it is the whole boss here analyzing the damage. Now, scanning is continuous. Just wait. You both have to wait. You do, and I'm also waiting for it. Of the data was analyzed. The remaining are in progress. It is not so much easy. Finally, we are just following a few of these steps, but it's done. Estimated time left is 4 minutes. Let's see how much time it will take. Now sealant in the third stage. So analyzing other contents here. There is all the deleted documents in the C drive. So just to first. So it's not moving. So here we have to give it a location where we have to recover that files. So I'll cover this file so that we get stuck over here. Just check in the desktop, we have to search for the recovery files folder, and here are all the documents which we have loaded. We will recover from the Recuva tool now. That's all about this. Thank you so much.